Santa Rosa Mountains, Coachella Valley. It was Indian Wells, California, and perfect weather if you don't mind the heat. It's been a little warm, but very little breeze, and it's nice to be at this stage of a match here because even I can even feel like a little tingle here from my men's cross partner, Pam Shriver. Nice. Women's final coming up.
Yeah, this is a final we thought we'd see when we showed up here in the desert about a week ago. 5'6", but has a lot of power for someone 5'6". Look at that match record in 2004. Her only loss came a couple of weeks ago in Doha to Kuznetsova, who she got some revenge from here in the quarterfinals. As you see, her path through to the finals has not dropped a set, although Kuznetsova had set points, and Meskina gave very little resistance in the semifinals.
Hometown girl, not exactly hometown, but very close. Lindsay Davenport, Laguna Beach is home for her.
Also, just one loss on the year. That was to Anna Arden, the quarters. We talked about that in the Open at the Australian Championships. She won a tournament in Tokyo the week after Melbourne, and then took some time off until this tournament. So she came in here well-rested and in a very good frame of mind.
Davenport had a bye in the first round here, and for her in the second round, as you can see, this has been a pretty easy road.
Yeah, neither player dropped the set, but again, both players had set points against them. For Davenport, it was in the semis in a really fun second set against Deshi. Just barely eked out that tiebreak.
Davenport leading 5-2, but that Australian Open meeting this year that you've already talked about may linger a little more closely in the mind of these two as they start this match. Pam, what are we going to see? What kind of a match?
Well, I think from Davenport, you're going to see her usual big-hitting stuff. I mean, she said going into this that she knows she needs to concentrate well throughout. I actually think the intangibles are going to play a crucial role here because we know Anna Arden is so strong mentally right now. She's not lost before the semifinals in a year, and she's been so tough to beat in finals, winning the three major finals she's been in, all against Kim Clijsters.
Championship match, best of three, first ball.
59.
There's the serve right away. Serving up the good end. The sun is much more difficult, the end that Anna Arden is receiving from now. Served in the mid-70%, first serves in the semis. Shots in a rally after a good first serve. Davenport had a pretty easy forehand and didn't do much with it. That gave Anna Arden the chance to step on top of the rally, and Davenport was never able to get back to neutral.
Good rhythm so far in the serve. It helped her at the end of the only match in which she was really challenged. And if she can start out serving this way, it'll be a lot of trouble for Anna Arden.
First serve she's missed. She got her money's worth, too. It was about a yard and a half long. Talk a lot about the first serve, but the second serve is vital as well. The other day, that was really Davenport's only weak part of her serve. She was struggling to win points against Deshi on the second serve. So you can imagine with the same quality second serves, the problem she's going to have today against the number one player.
Early match nerves, yeah, that are inevitable in a championship match, both players.
I was just thinking how easy it is to sort of overhit a little bit when you're adrenaline's up at the start of the match. So missing a ball like that just long, being aggressive is okay.
Same point.
You think Nardin was leaning towards the middle of the court? It was a good 104-mile-an-hour first serve. Nardin picked it. Look at that return.
Advantage.
It's the first big pressure point, really, on serve. Davenport struggled in Australia 2 months ago, winning the deuce games, particularly after the 4-love lead. And Davenport remembered that and spoke about it the other day, that she needs to win the long games, or at least her share. And because it's on Davenport's mind that she needs to win the deuce-ad long game, this very first game on her serve is even more important, since it has gone to deuce now twice.
I sense this is going to be this kind of a match, up and down for every game, hard fought for every point.
Davenport led 40-15 in this game, hasn't been able to win any of her three game points.
Great
first
point now.
Break chance.
Oh, that's tough. Break a serve first game. Here is Lindsay on Justine.
I mean, Justine's going to be obviously a really tough opponent. She's done so well over the last year and, you know, had a tough match with her in Australia, which I lost. So, you know, it's exciting because you feel like you have nothing to lose, but I really want to play well and do well in California and hopefully win the tournament. But I'm going to have to really look to not let her dictate and let her move me around the court. I mean, she's such a great backhand. She's really improved her serve a lot. I'm just going to have to try and get her to make a few more errors than she's used to.
And from 40-15 up in that game, Anna Arden was the one that did dictate play. Career wins over number one. Davenport has a whole heap. Most of those against Hingis. And Hingis was number one in the so much of the time in the late 90s and early 2000s.
Double fault on her first serve point of the match in Arden, love 15, but she has a breaker serve in the first set.
Oh. It's an interesting start on serve in a final. Double fault the first point. Ace second serve as we look at the Progressive Auto Insurance shot spot, showing that that second serve could not be any more accurate. We don't see many second serve aces in the women's game.
Didn't see many in the men's game either. A few more maybe.
Perfect example of how Davenport can dictate play with one strike on the return of serve. She hits the off backhand return, and it sets up a forehand winner down the line.
Hingis not here because she's out. She's retired.
And Davenport there, Lindsay's mom. Alongside Adam Peterson, Jonathan Leach, Lindsay's husband, already sweating up a storm. Oh.
40-30.
Two aces and a service winner. That's where the first serves went against Mesquina. Really likes the one up the tee on the ad side.
Game point in Arden. Oh, that's good. Excellent defense that turned into offense. Point in our game and game. Two games to left first set.
Boy, Davenport hasn't had a bad start of the match, but Anna Arden is just showing why she sits on top of women's tennis and why she deserves those three major championships, all the Tier 1 events she's won in the last 12 months.
Eight winners in Arden, one unforced error. Huh. Quick start.
Cannot start a final any better than Anna Arden has done this one. Mm. Can Davenport kind of ride out this storm? Anna Arden started beautifully in her last couple of matches against Kuznetsova, and then Meskina really didn't show much resistance at all. Can Davenport keep her concentration and stay positive enough so that when Arden comes down a little bit, she's ready to take advantage? Right now, there's very little Lindsay can do. She can't, for example, Cliff, kind of mix up the play and or the pace. She's not about that as a tennis player.
Got to try to get first strike in if she can, but this returning of serve has been spectacular. 10 winners now for Anna Arden. 10 in just a couple of games.
And it's really hard not to start to press, even though it's just love 2, love 30 in this game. Davenport may want to try and step things up, but she's not really ready to do that. It was a pretty good second serve right at the corner, and Arden tried to hit a topspin off return angle winner. Carlos Rodriguez to the right, Pat Echeverry to the left. Longtime coach Carlos Rodriguez there has just been such a steady influence.
Out of reach. Two in a row for Davenport. 30 all in this game. Pat Echeverry is the strength and fitness coach for Anna Arden.
And Lindsay Davenport actually has her own fitness coach here, Todd Norman. It's the first time Lindsay has brought a fitness trainer to a tournament. He works out of Orange County, a cutting edge gym. Lindsay is as fit as she's ever been.
30 all. Game point for Davenport. She had game points on her first serve game. Wasn't able to complete the job, though, and she's down 2 games to none.
Boy, if she can hold serve from love 30, she'll sort of feel like she got one back from losing her opening service game from 40-15. And we know Davenport, one of the great returners, is most likely going to find a way to break serve once each set at least. That second serve pressure that Anna Arden applied late in the first game on Davenport's serve paid off there. Anna Arden was sneaking around, trying to hit a big forehand. Davenport knew it, tried to hit a more precise, more aggressive second serve, and double faulted.
That's the power game of Davenport that got to be able to somehow use more effectively. That two-hander hit so flat. In fact, her ground strokes off both sides are flat. Davenport's mom, an outstanding volleyball player, as was her dad. 2-1 in Arden. First point, Justine Anna Arden serving here. 2-1. She's in front and 15 love now. Mr. Sutton, thank you for your sponsorship. What a great company, and have them involved with this great championship in tennis.
Yeah, no wonder they're a fabulous company. Been around 135 years. I didn't know that. He's older than us put together.
There's not many of them left. 15 love, 2-1 in a Ardennes. Looking up into the sun, it's not a good time. There's 12:25, but I got news for Justine. It's not going to get any better in the next hour and a half. So you have to throw that ball in such a way that you don't look into the sun, obviously.
Hear the voice of Roland Herfel of Germany. He's in charge of this match, instructing the ball girl. And Ardennes is learning that when you're the number one player in the world, you play a lot of night matches during the week, so she's not as conditioned to the sun.
Well, she plays a lot of night matches because she's number one, and also as you take a look there, you're looking right up into the sun. It's tough right there where she is now. Also with Jennifer Capriati not being here, out with injury, the Williams sisters not here either because of injury, more likely because of the political problems that they have with the tournament from a couple of years ago. When this crowd got onto them both and the family because it was such a late pullout. I guess it was Venus pulled out right at the last minute, or was it Serena?
Yeah, Mary Jo and I were like 30 seconds from live air to show Williams versus Williams, and we got word that Venus was defaulting, withdrawing from the match with tendonitis in one of her knees. And in the finals against Kim Clijsters, Serena walked out to the stadium court to mostly boos, and when Richard Williams and Venus took their seat in the family box, they also got booed. It was a pretty unfortunate scene.
Having said that, neither Williams sister played at the end of last year after Wimbledon, and Venus tried to make a comeback this year at the Australian Open, but it was not a successful. In fact, this year has not been very successful.
Venus hasn't gotten to a quarterfinal yet. They're both scheduled to play next week in Miami. They both look good to go. And also, they're going to play. I think Serena's entered in both the Bausch & Lomb at Amelia Island and Family Circle in Charleston.
Game point in Ardennes, 2-1, first set.
Two double faults on that side of the court. Indeed. One into the net, one long. And Davenport knows that she's got a little edge when Anna Ardennes serving into the sun. And with two double faults, it's deuce. Davenport wants to take advantage.
All of Justine's errors are double faults. Played, apart from that, a very clean match.
Hardly getting any first serves then in, though. Only four for the match, and she hasn't lost a point when she gets the first one in.
Second
serve and neck cord. Davenport in her usual spot this tournament in the 70s first serve percentage. I actually think that miss hit on the forehand, Justine kind of went to her eyes again. She had to serve three serves with a net cord, and she is definitely struggling with her vision both during the serve and during the rally on this side.
Great point.
Another one of these games, Cliff. Do sad, the long games.
Pam, Lindsay was number one in the world, obviously. Not for that long, though. And we were talking at the top of the show about those who sit comfortably at the top of the world. I'm not sure, though, that she's to blame, I mean, mentally, for not wanting to be there or giving it her best effort to be there. Because she just had a lot of competition with when the Williams sisters came along.
Yeah, that's right. They started to really come on just around when Lindsay was sharing that number one spot with Hingis, after Hingis sort of let go of her run of consecutive weeks at the top. Davenport has to be careful when she opens up the court advantage to the angle and hasn't done it with great aggression, putting Nardin on the defensive. Nardin so quick and can come up with a lot of different shots, and we know Davenport doesn't scamper as well. Three double faults all on that side in this game.
Four for the match. Davenport has had her chance. Well, she's only had the one break chance, but she had chances to hold her first serve game that she didn't.
Boy, oh boy, when you're having this kind of a problem with your serve, getting them in, now going to be below 30% first serves in. You've just sometimes got to spin it in.
That's too good. Out of reach of Davenport and a game point for the very speedy Nardin. Look at it.
You know, I was just thinking, perhaps a lower first serve percentage for Nardin isn't that big a deal, because her second serve, except for the ad side during this game, her second serve is fairly aggressive. We've already seen her hit an ace on the second serve. She's just really struggling on this side now, where the sun is at its worst.
Game. And out.
Survives a challenge, and Nardin wins the game 3-1. First set.
Doubles championships were decided yesterday, and the number one team in the world, Virginia Ruano Pascual and Paula Suarez, easily over the Russian tandem of Kuznetsova and Lehotseva. And then it's a French title on the men's side, Arnaud Clément and Sebastian Grosjean. Tight match over Black and Ouellette
of Zimbabwe.
Bryan twins lost fairly early here in an upset. They've really taken men's doubles by storm the last year or so. Lovely. Secured a Davis Cup position. Much needed, more of a sure thing to get that doubles win on a Saturday.
Love 15, 3-1 in Nardin.
Davenport staying fairly positive early in this final, despite the fact she's fallen into the same pattern and trap as she did down in Australia, which means losing close games, losing games where she either has break points or game points. See how much court coverage Nardin needs in order to stay in that rally.
Come as no surprise to you, Pam, but I really think that Davenport has got to try to finish these points off quickly. The first strike for her is so important. Nardin is quick. She moves so well.
Well, that's why her serve is so important, because that is the ultimate first strike. Service percentage has dipped below 70%. First time we've seen that in a couple of matches. Oh! Whoa. She knew she had that that hole up the center, just missed it long.
Net.
See, Davenport was hitting these serves the other day against Deshi, and she needs to in this final.
30-14.
That is a really bad mistake from Davenport. She had that clearly in her sights. That's the kind of shot, second to the serve, that she needs to make.
And I feel like the fact that her serve is not working well crept into that last shot, the unforced error on the forehand.
Great point.
Game.
Anna Arden is the world's top player. She's got a couple of breaks now in the first set. 4-1. Seesaw games. Anna Arden in the lead. Top player in the world here in the women's, Justine Anna Arden in front, 4-1, two breaks of serve. This is the championship match of the Pacific Life Open. We're live here in the Indian Wells Tennis Garden. And you are invited to stay tuned with us as the number one player in the men's, Roger Federer, will take on a man that he's only beaten once in seven tries, the Brit, Tim Henman.
Who's looking very comfortable and confident out here. Talked to him a bit this morning, and he's been around such a long time that he's very relaxed about everything, as is Federer. Talk about someone who seems to be comfortable at number one. That's the problem for Davenport when she opens up the angles for Anna Arden. Moves well to the ball. That backhand. Anna Arden has so much versatility. She can slice it. She can topspin it. She can go down the line, cross court. It's a nightmare for the opponent.
Let's tell the Davenport story, Pam. 27 years old, married for less than a year now, just on about a year. Three-time slam winner. She's won three slam titles.
Every one except the French. Starting off with a 98 U.S. Open, following it up with a 99 Wimbledon, and then 2000 Australian. Beat Hingis twice and Groff once in those finals. Won an Olympic gold in Atlanta.
Parents both excellent athletes, volleyball competition-wise.
Today she's going for her 40th overall title, which it's a lot of titles.
Ooh. Her dad, Wink, engineer, played Olympic volleyball in 68. Mom is or was president of the Southern Cal Volleyball Association. But she's in trouble in this first set of the championship match. She's won this twice. She's going for three. She'd be the first woman ever to win the Pacific Life three times.
Our fellow ESPN teammate, Mary Jo Fernandez, one of four players to have won it twice, along with Davenport, Serena, and Martina Navratilova. Oh, but I'll tell you, the way this match is shaping up right now, Davenport may have to wait another 14, year 15, or so. Yeah. You can see most career titles. Navratilova, Gaudy, along with Everett and Groff, all three winning over 100. Margaret Court, Goolagong King, some of their titles, especially Court and King, came before open tennis. Same with Virginia Wade and Celis and Hingis.
Game. And out there.
Lindsay's in the top 10.
5-1. Justine Anna Arden, and kind of fun to go on to ESPN.com right now and you key in the keyword tennis and you can scroll down and hook on to information about tennis welcome centers. New way of trying to get you into the game or into fun games. Type in your zip code. You can find out all the parks and public courts where you can learn to play. Work on your game. Typed in both my zip code in Los Angeles and in Baltimore, so I'm all hooked up.
15 love Davenport here, 5-1 to Anna Arden.
Net, second set.
Oof. Tennis is the sport of a lifetime.
Yes.
So instead of just going out there with a wife or hubby, just go on out and go to the Welcome Center. Find out where you can. They'll hook you up with a game that'll work for you.
And you'll be fitter and healthier and probably enjoy watching tennis a lot more too, which we certainly care about at ESPN. It shows that people who play tennis want to watch the best play.
15 all.
And right now, you're watching the best in women's tennis. Justine Anna Arden of Belgium. Hard to believe two Belgians sit on top of women's tennis. Anna Arden has taken full advantage of the void that particularly Serena Williams left when she got injured at Wimbledon last year, hasn't played since.
13.
Serena had won five of the previous six Grand Slams, six majors before that injury. And Arden has won three of the last four played, two without Serena in the draw. There's no weakness in this game, Cliff. Do you see a weakness in Arden's game?
No, just the only thing that can get to her is power. And Davenport's got power, but she just has made way too many unforced errors today, balanced by the fact that Arden hasn't made any.
Oh.
Arden holds easily six games to one. As the change ends, we'll take a break. This is the big one, the championship match of the Pacific Life.
A lot to be happy about if you're a Belgian tennis fan these days. We had a couple of enthusiastic ones here at the stadium at the Pacific Life Open. Justine Anna Arden won the first set 6-1, but look at this on the last point. Watch her feet, a little bit of a stumble. She gets stuck there, almost trips over her right foot. But what does she do? She recovers beautifully. And she hits a forehand winner. I mean, she's doing everything well. She even loses her balance, regains it, and hits a winner on set point.
Yeah, it's like that right foot got stuck there because it's a hot day. Take a look at these stats.
Well, the only thing you can criticize about Anna Arden is her first serve percentage. It's terrible, but guess what? All seven that she got in, she won the points, and she was 50% with her second serve. Hit four double faults, but she won games when she served three double faults. The one game. And now it's a big mental hurdle for Davenport to get over the quality of play that Anna Arden showed in that first set.
A little bit of the Anna Arden story, Pam. She was from Belgium, a country of about 10 million people, two languages there, Flemish and French. She's from the French-speaking part. Lost her mother relatively young, and she said that kind of made her grow up pretty quickly. She's kind of estranged, hadn't spoken to her father for a long time now, married to Pierre-Yves.
Pierre-Yves, not here. Doesn't go everywhere. Goes most places, certainly the majors. This isn't the reason why he's not here, but he's getting his pilot license. Justine will not go up in the plane with him. She says now or in the future.
Justine met him when she was giving him a prize for winning a minor tournament in Belgium.
She gave him a prize, all right.
Fifteen, 13.
And Pam, we were talking earlier today about really what turned things around for her and what catapulted her to number one, starting with the French Championships when she took out Serena Williams, or did it?
Two big matches played earlier in the year last year. One was against this opponent today, Lindsay Davenport, the round of 16 at last year's Australian Open, 9-7 in the third. Anna Arden battled through all sorts of demons in that match to win it, including 15, cramps 14. And a recent history of not winning those majors, and also beat Serena in the finals of Family Circle, a Tier 1 event.
This is a break point for Davenport, first game, second set.
And it is just huge that Davenport converts one of these 2 points.
And she does. Anna Arden's had trouble from that side.
Well, all started the big major wins at the French. That was last June over Clijsters Serena in the semis. A few months later, the Open. Capriati in the semis, 6 in the third, and then Clijsters again. Can she win 3 of 4? Same opponent in the finals, same result, this time in 3 sets.
She has won the big ones against Kim Clijsters for sure. 3, only Wimbledon is lacking.
It's interesting, Wimbledon's the only one she hasn't won, and yet it was her first major final back in 2001, losing in 3 sets to Venus Williams when Venus defended her title.
I don't know, Andre Agassi went through that same thing. He played the final of the French twice, and the French was the last slam that he won. I think that Anna Arden is going to end up winning all 4 slams, if not in the same year. She's definitely a candidate to win Wimbledon.
Oh, she's got a great all-court game. She says clay's her favorite surface, but with the way she can serve and volley. Oh, bad correction. The ball was out. It was a fault. But Lindsay will take it. Eye on the ball the whole time through impact. A little bit of an open stance. Short in the court with a bit of an angle. That's what did the trick on that one. She's looking up at the sun a long time here. And that's why she missed the forehand. She had to take the first one in the air.
Well, also she missed that overhead. Must have been looking into the sun. That couldn't have been an easy overhead. She didn't put it away.
But once she let it bounce, that meant she was looking up into the sun while it was in the air the first time, and then after it bounced. And I just think, as tough as it is up that end, that was the wrong way to play it. You had to get to it sooner.
30 all.
Davenport may get away with that mistake. It was a small mistake, but still, I mean, that was for 40-15, but she still has a game point here.
I wouldn't characterize it as a small mistake, Pam. I thought that overhead, that was a gift, a gimme.
Well, the mistake was just not going for it in the
right
air.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Game point.
Oh.
Davenport holds. Now the first set, 6-1, looks like it was easy. In fact, a couple of points in the first few games of that set, and the whole momentum of the set may have been different. That question, or that observation, may have some truth to it in the second set. We'll find out, because Davenport now off to a good start.
And Arden has struggled some in second sets in this tournament. A round of 16 against Barbara Strakova. She was down 1-4 in the second set, and Kuznetsova had set points to take the second set in the quarters. There's the Davenport camp. Mom, coach, husband, fitness trainer. Ugh. And Davenport, for the first time, has grabbed the momentum. No, it's just 15 all in this game. She is now starting to do that first strike, getting on top in a rally pretty soon. Decision making and how quickly you have to do it. The drop shot here, Davenport scampers well. She's 6'2 and a half. This is not the strength of her game. And NR didn't know whether to let it bounce, but that would have given Davenport time to recover. She did a little stutter step and then hit the volley, even though it was below the net. That was the right play. Good decision.
30-15. Do you think Serena 14, Williams is going to be able to come back to Miami and win the title next week?
Well, and Arden's not playing. That's one help for Serena. We'll see how. I think the first couple of matches just crucial for Serena to settle in and get comfortable again with facing break points and serving for sets. She's seen what her sister has gone through three tournaments of a comeback starting in January at the Australian Open. And it has been a struggle for Venus. But remember, Serena was playing better tennis the year and a half prior to their absence.
That one sails, 40-30. This crowd rooting maybe a little bit for the local. Lindsay Davenport, as that one clips the line.
Well, two reasons to root for Davenport. One, she's from Southern California. She's a familiar face out here playing at the Pacific Life Open, and
she's the underdog.
The underdog.
Game point.
Like so many young number ones and champions, Anna Arden is respected but not loved yet. Saw Chris Evert go through that, Groff, Navratilova. Celis.
Game.
Hingis.
And Arden.
And Arden is on the board in the second. Lindsay Davenport with a break will serve when we come back live to the Pacific Life. Live coverage, Pacific Life Open Championship match this Sunday afternoon. We'll start our coverage next week on Sunday afternoon from Miami of the NASDAQ 100. For the moment, there's so much at stake here between these two. Last time they played, it was Justine and Arden in a very close match down in Australia. We're in the second set, 2-1, breaker serve, Davenport.
15-0.
Get a quick reminder, if you're planning the rest of your afternoon, not that far away now, please. Tim Henman, Great Britain, taking on Roger Federer for the men's. Coming up.
We'll see some good all-court tennis in that match.
Betcha. Got it.
She made it look easy. That is a short, low ball with that extreme grip to hit the topspin. Davenport did a pretty good little job here to flick this one. Actually, it was a little bit higher than I thought because Arden was so quick to get up to the ball. That first step forward is crucial to make that an easier shot.
Relatively early in the year, and Anna Arden she wins this, it would be her fourth title of this year, including the Australian Open, the first slam of the year. 30 all in this game, big point.
The other two in Sydney and Dubai. Oh.
Oh. Missed it.
Wow. Seldom do you see Anna Arden with an open court on that backhand side. She didn't need to hit it close to the sideline. Davenport decided to pick the line. She gave a look to the chair umpire, but this ball, as shot spot will show you, is well wide, and that was a big point to get a break point, to get the break back.
Game point, Davenport. And Lindsay holds 3-1 second set now.
Boy, 2 points ago, that was just a huge point. If Davenport could send this to a third set and find a way to win this final, we'll remember that backhand miss of Anna Arden's.
Anastasia Mesquina is creeping up on Lindsay for the number four spot in world rankings. Mesquina is number five now. Lindsay will stay at four after this, getting to the final.
Yeah,
double fault. Boy, she served all of her double faults that side where she's serving into the suns, having a lot of trouble with that.
Next week with Serena coming back, she will have a protected seeding of number three, even though Serena's ranking has slipped. She's about to slip out of the top 10.
That is called wide. You're watching live coverage, Pacific Life Open Women's Singles Championship match. Cliff Drysdale here, Pam Shriver alongside. It's Justine Anna Arden, Lindsay Davenport watching the replay there, called wide. And it's 15 all in this game. First set, Anna Arden 6-1. Second set, 3-1, Davenport with the break.
That's where Davenport struggles. When she's on the run, has to cover over half the court. Tried to do something a little extra. And Arden has the big advantage, and she has to scamper out wide. The unforced errors are starting to come into the number one player in the world's game a lot more in this second set. Eight total already, more than half of what she had in the first set through just four and a half games.
Who moves quicker than in our Denver women's tour field?
I think when the Williams sisters are healthy, they cover more court. They cover it differently, both much longer legs, particularly Venus. Totally different look of movement.
So in a 12-yard dash, would they beat Justine?
Oh, maybe not in the 12. I don't know. Two big steps, and the Williams sisters are there.
Yeah.
We'll start that new event on the tour later this year, the 12-yard dash. I suppose on a tennis court.
That's what you need.
Yeah.
Game point, Arden.
game. Enarden.
Enarden holds. 3-2. Still a break of serve. Davenport will serve into the sun when we come back here to the Pacific Life Championship match.
Last week on Dream Job.
Alongside Aaron Levine.
Better crowds than ever here at this Pacific Life Open this year. It's a huge stadium. Can seat some 18,000 if it's jammed. They're watching Lindsay Davenport here and Justine Anna Arden. First set, Arden 6-1. It was a little closer than the score, frankly. 3-2 now. Davenport up with a break. But this is the tough side to serve for.
That's the shot Davenport needs to either hit a winner or really force the play. But because it has no pace, or very little pace, just not that easy.
Love 30.
Look out, love 30. At 3-2 for Davenport. Big point.
Oh, and that left hand goes up. Saw that left hand at a crucial time in the third set at the French in the semis against Serena. Caused all sorts of controversy because the chair umpire didn't see it. But there, you could hear Justine with her voice sort of say also, wait a minute. These are the games Davenport must find a way to still hold. The other day against Deshi, she did it with huge first serves. Not serving quite as well today, serving just 64% first serves in, which is still pretty good. But the other day, she was 10-12% higher against Deshi with a lot more aces.
Two in a row for Davenport in this crucial game, 30-0. Kim Kleist has played one match, injured herself, pulled out against Laura Granville of the U.S., got a walkover. There was some talk about being out for 6 weeks, Pam. What's the update?
Well, she hasn't officially pulled out of Miami. There was some word that she had, but no. Oh, bad luck for Davenport, who hit the big serve, had the rally, but the net court just turned the rally around in a split second right here. Wasn't a service winner, but it was just as good on a crucial point. This was against Deshi. These are the aces that Davenport served. 10 total. Look at the extremes. Today, just 2 aces.
Advantage, and now down.
Just missed. You could see, though, Anna Arden, where was she? She was right there. She may have chased Davenport to hit it a little bit wider.
Break point.
Game. Anna Arden.
Anna Arden breaks. She hit one backhand passing shot there that got her into this game in a serious way. Let's just take a look at it. As she takes it back here, this is very artistic way. Look at it, totally sideways now, right? Look at the shoulders, way back there. Eyes on the ball, now she starts to swing in. The shoulders haven't started to open yet, have they? Not until after she hits the ball. That is the big lesson for her. Then look how she lets it go, balancing her right arm with her left arm. It's very, very nice looking backhand. And it's textbook too, by the way.
See, she has 6 backhand winners, 10 forehand winners, which is true to her pattern recently. She has more forehand winners than backhand. but also balances it nicely with a couple of aces and three volley winners. She can hurt you from any part of the court.
Three games all, 15 love now. She was 3-1 down in the second.
What I like, Cliff, is how many different kinds of backhands Anna Arden can hit. The other day when you went through that same topspin shot, she actually hit it with more of an open stance. On that one you just showed, her right leg was the forward leg. More traditional way of hitting the ball. And, of course, the slice.
Absolutely. I mean, it's the variety that she has on that side that makes it so difficult to play against her. You know, 15-30 in this game, heads up.
Yeah.
But it's the same thing with Roger Federer. He can slice or come over the backhand equally effectively.
Yeah, she just missed one of those backhands. Put herself in some trouble in this game.
Speaking of tennis artists, Roger Federer of Switzerland, world's number one in the men's, he's up next against Tim Henman. Last time Henman played the championship match was a dog, but this one, I can virtually guarantee you a good match.
Two break points here for Davenport, who's taken advantage and loving the fact that the last 2 points were unforced errors from that backhand side. But the tough little Belgian, number one in the world, comes up with an ace to fight off one of the two break points. Oh, just said how she can hurt you from all parts of the court. She stayed on top because of the big first serve. She had a forehand, a backhand, comes to net, just carves underneath that volley, hits it short and into the open court. Davenport doesn't even run for it.
Deuce. Just lining up that Tuffman backhand again there. Lethal and game point Arden.
It's an 83 mile an hour backhand winner here, and the point started off with her fastest serve of the match, 114. You don't think Anna Arden at 3-all, having gotten the break back, that she doesn't see a finish line for this championship, a place where she struggled. She has not played well at the Pacific Life Open to afford this year.
Davis break point down, but holds. He's up 4-3.
I wear black.
Variety really sums up Anna Arden's game. The Pacific Life match summary will show you how she can hurt you with forehand winners. Cliff just took you through her beautiful backhand, and she can go cross court or down the line. She can hurt you from the net as well. Her reach, her ability to scramble, recover from little trips on the court. This was at set point. Cross-court forehand winner. She has it all right now. And that important bit of intangible belief that you can win not only majors, tier one events. She's also learned to win when she's not playing her best. She's somewhere in the middle in this match. 24 winners, more winners than unforced. Differential of 6. Cliff is about the same stature as Martina Hingis. Perhaps 1 inch taller, but that's it. But boy, what a difference in the power quotient.
A little quicker than Hingis? Or was Hingis as good a mover?
Boy, Hingis was a really good mover as well. Perhaps a little more powerful mover when she gets to the net.
30 love Davenport, and to me, these next two games are huge in this match. Because Davenport, if she can hold here with the sun behind her, in the next game it will be Anna Arden with the sun into her face, and she's had trouble from that side. So here is Davenport's chance. She's got 30-15.
Oh, 40-15. Not enough of those today, but a lot of her big aces, Davenport in the semis, came late in that second set, just when she needed them. This one cannot be placed any more perfectly.
Davenport holds. The forehand, such an important part of her arsenal. Take a quick look at how she does it. She gets a high take back. The racket gets high, and that's one thing. But I'll tell you why she's able to watch it as we freeze it right there. See how it's come down now? It's about parallel to the ball, and she goes straight into the ball. So it's a relatively flat shot. Now look at the finish. It's also pretty high. It takes a lot of talent. She has got good ball control on that forehand. Unlike the heavy top spinner, she doesn't let the racket get too far below the ball when she's coming into it. Not many that hit the ball on the forehand side like she does, by the way.
More serve winners and volley winners than forehand or backhand winners from Davenport today. 14 total, just one less than the unforced error tally.
39.
A relatively tame from Davenport here with the serve game of Anna Arden. It's crucial. 4-4, second set. Ever there was a time to juice up the energy, this is it for Davenport. Not much you can do about that.
No, and Davenport's not known for being a big juicer. I mean, she tends to just kind of ride whatever mood is out there on the court anyway. And I think sometimes she could benefit from just trying to, even artificially, just pump herself up a little bit on these crucial times. Anna Arden does it wonderfully.
Game point. And a well-played game that time from Anna Arden from that side. And it's 5-4. Davenport to serve to try to stay in the match when we come back live. Sun is out and it's hot. It's been like that since the beginning here in the California desert. It is a desert after all. What do you expect? Pacific Life, live coverage. We're closing in on what could be the end of this match. 6-1, 5-4 in our den. Love 15.
Love 15.
A bit of a high loopy mix-up play on the forehand from Anna Arden. Davenport had to reach up. Different shot for her.
Oh, that's very smooth from Lindsay Davenport, because there's a lot of bounce in the step of Anna Arden. She comes in, but just watch this from Davenport. Remember, this is a big point.
Well played from both players' standpoint. Anna Arden applied the pressure to Davenport. Davenport was well behind the baseline, able to find the angle. Variety, variety, variety. Finish line, finish line. Anna Arden is so tough. She has not played this shot in this entire final. back foot, heavy topspin, drops just inside the baseline. She's now 2 points from the championship. That's one of those first serves. Wasn't an outright winner, but it set up the next shot.
31.
Just an automatic play. Serve out wide, belt it into the open court. And you need set plays on big points.
Whoa, doing exactly the right thing there, trying to pressure Lindsay, but she came up with the shot. Kind of going for the knockout punch there. Mistake, and it's game point, Davenport.
Gotten to Davenport. That one produced differently than the first one, which was a topspin winner. This one more of a flat push, awkwardly over the backhand side.
And Davenport's got another game point. So close to the end of this match, but we're on serve.
Advantage.
And Davenport serving this point for five apiece in the second. Really could happen.
Just wondering what that second serve percentage wins. In this set, it's not bad. 50% for the match, though. 35%. Fourth double fault. One more double fault than ace.
It's the first double fault of the set. She got there in time, but not in enough time to make the shot. And this is a match point for NRD.
Again, the different and new shots that we haven't seen throughout this final, NRD is producing in what might be the last game of this tournament.
Championship point. Arden has 17 WTA singles titles in her career, 39 for the 27-year-old Davenport in Arden's 21. That lob play is so smart into the sun at this stage, and another championship point for NRDN.
Well, that rally forces NRDN into the shade on her second match point, championship point coming up. Looking into the sun, Davenport had this point several different ways. Return off a big first serve out wide. Davenport had to quickly get out of the way and hit a forehand cross court, force the error.
The return was actually so good, Pam, that NRDN didn't have time to recover. Deuce. Crowd want to see some more tennis, but that was brilliant stuff again from Enarden. Very controlled. That lob over Davenport's head was perfect. This is a championship point again.
Games when it's a match game, three match points now for Enarden. Davenport has just come up with clutch stuff because Enarden has not given her many opportunities. She's had to earn them. And if Davenport can find a way to just squeak through and hold serve, will Enarden feel a little extra pressure at 5-all?
Yes.
Thought so. Crowd trying to help as well. That also is Davenport's fastest serve of this match, 107.
Enarden's fastest, 114. Fourth championship point coming up for Enarden. Big return out of reach of Lindsay.
Can Lindsay come up with another big first serve championship point down? Living on the edge, but if you can find a way to hold serve, survive all these championship points, even for Enarden, that can mentally weigh heavily on her.
That'll sail. Another chance for the championship for Enarden.
Advantage, Enarden.
This game now over 10 minutes long. Match has been an hour and 21 minutes.
That's gone.
6-1, 6-4.
Very businesslike, Pam. It was just well played, really, from the start. She struggled, she fought when the chips were down, and she was ready to make a move at the end there. You could see a little spry step from her as she made her move and wins another WTA Tour Tier 1 title.
Yeah, she has just been so tough in all the majors and all the Tier 1 events the last 12 months. And It was the first of the championship points, the fifth one, where she finally picked a serve of Davenport. She was leaning, looking towards the center. She pounced on the return and then hit the winner. I mean, the maturity of this woman in the last 12 months to handle the big occasion and to come into these finals and feel almost routine has really been something to watch.
Yeah, when you say, you know, we can come up with the ifs, ands, and the buts and the chances that were not taken maybe by Lindsay in a certain way, but when the chips are, it really is Anna Arden who has got so much confidence as a result of all that winning she's done here in the last 12 months.
And for Davenport, I mean, she has to sort of think about how she can make the breakthrough again against the top players. But I'll tell you what a stubborn opponent. Justine Anna Arden joins us courtside. Justine, an amazing second set, particularly the last game. You had to come out with every trick, topspin lob winners, lobs over the backhand side, drop shots. Tell us about that last game just to win the championship.
I did everything. You know, I had to be patient. She was serving so well on the match point, so I just waited for an opportunity, and I think I just did everything I had to do, and it worked pretty good at the end of the match.
Justine, take a breath. Take it easy. I know this is a big moment for you. It's another tournament. Let's see. This is number 18 for you. Congratulations. Take a look at your monitor and see some of these shots that you played today. You're looking very quick, very fit from the start.
Oh, yeah, I moved pretty well today. You know, I had great defense. When Miss thought that the point was over, I was there. So I think that mentally is very important. And I stayed very calm in the second set when I was down. So it's good.
When you play these finals now, Justine, talk about the difference from like the last 12 months from previous in your career. How much relaxed and more confident are you going into these championships?
I love the finals day. I mean, that's pretty amazing. In tennis, you know, all this competition and the tension, I love it so much, and it helps me to be 100% during my finals.
Talk about the fact that when you started out against Lindsay, she beat you a lot, and then at the Australian this year, which is the last time you played, you beat her. So going into today, Justine, does that make a heck of a difference to you?
I'm a much better player for sure, and you know, I it was a little bit difficult in the past for me to play against the strong players since I started to work hard, since I started to believe in myself and in my power, so that's pretty good. And you know, it's unbelievable what happens right now, but I know that I deserve it.
Justine, you're taking Miami off, and women's tennis may look a little different if the Williams sisters really well and truly get into their comeback. Capriati gets healthy, hopefully Mauresmo. Obviously, you won your first major with everyone still there. It's been a little different field, but you seem ready to tackle anybody who's out there and in the draw.
I think I am ready, and I think it's going to be good for everybody that the top players are coming back healthy on the tour. It's going to be good for myself too, a lot of motivation, but I think that physically, mentally, my tennis is okay, so I think I'm ready for they come back.
It's more than okay, Justine. Well done.
Thank you, Ben.
Hey, Justine, they're ready for you to go take the check and your prize. Congratulations.
Thanks.
We'll take a break. We'll come back with the ceremony.